Hi friend, this is the sixth lecture that we are attending. Here we are considering that different issues, that is different topics, that is chapters related to the random variables in the probability function. So already I have shared one book in that your Google Drive or find in my Google Classroom that will giving that entire ideas of the central moment variance and entire distribution function and probability theory. You can study these books for the detail. Here I am just topically giving out or just in a precise term I'm just describing what is the fact of that. So today's our topic is variance of the central moment. Okay, so what is the variance? That is the central moment. And what is that expectation? That is called that mu, and that mu is a statistical average. Basically we are considering right there. So how to calculate that mu and that variance? Here I have already written that mean is called that expectation and variance is called the central moment. So normally PMF is considered, probability mass function is considered for that discrete random variables and for continuous random variables. That probability density function is considered. Now in the case of variance and the central moment, you can see that it estimate the probability distribution about the mean. So it estimate the probability distribution about the mean. It means if something is already considered as a mean, it is just used to finding out the distribution function that is centered about that mean. So if you are taking mean as a basis of the center, so you can easily distribute that other values which is surrounded by that or variated by that distribution or that particular value of the mean. So it can be expressed as that sigma x square equals to e of x minus mu x whole square. So what is e? That is the expectation. So what is the expectation? You can write it as x px in this way. If you are writing this sigma of x square, so it is e of x minus mu x, that's whole square. So finally summation of x minus mu x square into p of x, it can be written as for the discrete random variables. Now if you are considering it for the continuous random variable, you can write it as sigma x square equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x minus mu x whole square f of x dx. Here f of x is already I have told that is pdf, that is probability density function, and p of x equals to x, what I have told in the case of for the discrete random variables column, you can see. So that changes only for the discrete case you should consider the PMF. For the continuous case you have to consider that PDF, okay, and that remaining term will be the same. So the continuous random variables and the discrete random variables, the sigma value is just like the same. So by the use of the mean and the variance, we can easily understand and analyze the noise performance in a particular communication system. Now here the term has come which may be called as a covariance. So what is covariance? By the use of covariance, we can easily analyze the statistical mean of two random variables in communication system. So written as COV, cov, cov means covariance. Covariance x comma y equals to expectation of x minus mu x and y minus mu y. So expectation of the product of two random variables and x and y. So therefore e of mu y, for the case of autocorrelation we should multiply them, and what is the result? That e of, if you are multiplying these two, it means I want to mean that if you are multiplying this product inside, so what will be getting? That x y mu of x y, x of mu x mu y in this way. So in the case of autocorrelation, that this term e of x y here, we can easily write that this two term is cancelled out. So therefore it is e of xy minus mu x mu y. This is, and therefore the autocorrelation can be expressed in this way. Now by the use of joint PDF, we can write as f of xy here as small fxy of xy. So e of xy is what? Integration of minus infinity to plus infinity, double integration of x f of xy xy dx dy. So this term is called that correlation of two random variables x and y if they are in the phase of continuous, but if they are not in the phase of continuous, in the discrete in nature, so that is the output there. Now if two random variables as x and y are statistically independent, so I can write f of xy of xy, this is, that is equals to f of x and f of y of y. Okay, so put that equation in this one, you will be getting much more clear views on this. So what will be coming in that next phase, we should see that e of x comma y is integration of plus infinity to minus infinity, double integration f of xy x comma y dx dy. So if you are biparting it, so obviously minus infinity to plus infinity fx x dx into fx fy of y minus infinity plus infinity dy. So that is equals to e of x and e of y, so this is mu x and mu y. So covariance of xy is basically, that is e of xy, e of xy, if it is mu x and mu y, you are just putting this relation in that particular equation, you can see that covariance. So here e of xy of e of x comma y, it is mu x and mu y, so just putting this, you will be getting that covariance is equals to 0. So for two uncorrelated function, the covariance of two random variables is always 0. It is a very important factor, you have to know it. For two uncorrelated function, the covariance of two RV is always 0, but if they are correlated to each other, it will not 0, because that e of xy, it never equals to mu x and mu y then. But if it is a correlated function, so only it can be calculated. So finally, two random variables here x and y are uncorrelated or statistically independent. For when? If e of xy equals to e of x into e of y, it means expectation of individual statistical value if multiplied and getting that cumulative value for discrete random variables. So we can conclude in this way that expectation of x and y equals to e of x and e of y for the discrete random variables. For the continuous random variables, they can be classified as f of xy x comma y, that is fx into fy, and their product of the individual PDF. So what is the main topic of this particular lecture? Before going to this one particular point, that if you are considering the Gaussian PDF or the normal PDF used for the continuous random variables, you used to take this type of distribution, and what is the feature that is most important in the area of communication and majority of noise found in the Gaussian in nature and their additives called the white Gaussian noise, and therefore that function, if you are plotting, it look like that bell shaped function. Why? You can say that is the AGN channel or the Gaussian distribution channel, and in this particular Gaussian distribution channel, that f of x can be expressed as 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x, 1 by root over 2 pi sigma x e to the power minus x minus mu x whole square divided by 2 sigma x square. Now that is the, if you are integrating this, so obviously from x1 to x2 you are integrating, so obviously you are getting the probability of finding x between this particular range, because this is called that what? Integration of fx. So obviously it is a cumulative distribution function. Now if this is not a continuous random variable, so obviously the cumulative distribution function or CDF is quite different, but here in that case of probability of finding x between x and x1 and x2, so obviously it is an integration of this result, and basically probability of finding x between x1 and x2, it means we are finding out these values in this range, it means we are finding out the CDF, and specifically the CDF we want to find out between x1 and x2. Here the peak value is mu x. Okay, so the peak value is mu x. Mu x is what? It is the statistical mean. So it's statistical means, that is the mu x. So that term mu x, which is considered as a statistical means, is called the expectation. So here mu x is the mean of x, and its variance is what? Sigma x square is eventually spread in the two sides. So it is a mu x, and the variance is spread. Okay, so what I want to mean that that mean is this, and the variance is just taking in this way distributed. So that mu x, or that variance, the variance that is sigma x square, is eventually spread into two sides of the distribution function fx. So it is the bell-shaped function, and that particular distribution function is very much important of understanding the communication, because in which places the mu x is 1. Here, say if it is 1, so that is representing 1. If one particular function is like, where this is the mu x, so if it is a mu x, so obviously here mu x is 0. So if you are taking these two function, one function is like this and another function is like this, so obviously it representing 1 and it representing 0. Two functions are there, either 0 or 1. So this 0 and 1 can be taken cumulatively, and these particular functions are contaminated with that noise. So generally the noise figure as taken in this way. So in a communication channel, when you are receiving 1 or 0, in general cases, in a statistical eyes, we should say that two Gaussian distribution is received, in which one Gaussian distribution having mu x equals to 0 and sigma equals to 1, and the second case mu x equals to 1, sigma equals to 1. In this way, you are getting two Gaussian distribution function for 0 and 1 in a communication program. It may be in the case of receiver, may be in the case of transmitter. So in that both case of detection and estimation theory, that function is very, very much important. So this all for this today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will see what more we can do with that distribution function and that Gaussian distribution function, and more detail in that concept of AWGN, and somehow that calculation of ERFC is a special case of distribution function. See in my next lecture classes. So that's all for this today's class. And what is the summary of today's class? What we have discussed in today's class? First of all, we start discussing from this particular region, that here, that what is the covariance, and before that, what is the variance of the central moment for the case of discrete random variables, for the case of continuous random variables, and what is the covariance that you have calculated, that so the covariance concept, and the autocorrelation function we have already calculated. And finally, use of the joint PDF, how can write that covariance and that function, it is clear. Now, in that next part, if that functions are uncorrelated to each other, so the covariance of the two random variables is always 0. Already you have proved it. And finally, two random variables x and y is uncorrelated, so obviously we can write it is basically the product of these two. I mean, if you are having that expectation or that mean of this uncorrelated, if so the mean if multiplied, for the case of discrete case it will be giving that e of x y, for the continuous case it will be giving that multiplication of two inner product of their individual PDF. So when you are dealing with that continuous random variables, we have to find out that inner product of that individual PDF for that case of joint PDF, and for the case of independent already I have discussed. And secondly, what is a Gaussian PDF, or it is called the normal PDF. So I have discussed what is a Gaussian function and how we have considered for 1 and 0, what are the different cases. So in the next lecture we will be focusing much more onto this, and this particular lecture will be the ending of the 10th year session. Thank you very much, and see you all early next in my next class.